Fafnir. I always wonder what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was, and now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
Become a dragon, Mimir.
Oh, he's no friend of mine. His throat is a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Dwarf come dragon. For certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess. A lot's changed since we last crossed paths. I had legs.
Here. Boy.
Ah! I was wondering about this.
You wee little bugger. Well, I think Dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
I wonder why Goldie's bones are all over the place.
Desecration, typically. Pieces of scattered corpse make for a piss-poor soul. No hope for Valhalla or Helheim when your arm's on one beach and your head's on another.
Why not ask the spirit? I'm sure he will be forthcoming with answers.
Nicely done!
We have collected the rest of your woman's corpse spirit. Show us this magic you have promised.
Ah, my sweet Gulvig. Whole again. Rise, dear Gulvig. Awaken, O powerful Gulvig!
Erni ukar birthiast.
She says she'll honor our request.
Erdi fagnar.
And reunite us?
In Gowther!
Okay, you were right.
I told you so.
You are naive, foolish boy.
This is true as well. But do not take your disappointment out on me, boy. Take it as a lesson.
Yes, sir. Story before. So, how did this advisor of Odin's try to end the long war?
He set about to broker a peace between the gods. Took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
guys part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up.
Kavikia!
Well, worth a shot.
Runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read. Almost. If we could just find the other pieces of the language disc. I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. And we'll pick this up later.
Huh?
seriously. How did this one captain lead so many men?
He had their loyalty, so they followed.
And then they all died. He must have been a bad leader.
Why do you think that?
Well, he led all these men to their deaths.
True. But these men chose to follow. Even good leaders make poor choices. The best take responsibility for them. Remember this. Boy.
Yes, sir.
fall far.
That was the last ship. I hope the captain will be satisfied now.
Unlikely. He was determined to put these men to rest himself.
But he would have never been able to.
That does not matter to him. Our victory will only remind him of his failure.
Then, why do we do this?
Fire!